Hi everyone, I'm Jen. Do you ever find yourself being accused of causing another fine mess or another nice mess, whichever version of the quote you're familiar with in the Laurel and Hardy series? Intention to me is everything, and it reminds me of a student was expelled from school for bringing in a knife to a no weapons tolerated school. The thing that gets me though is she brought in a butter knife because she needed something to cut the homemade brownies that she brought in for her classmates and teacher. Was her intention to use the weapon in a hurtful way? Was the no tolerance for weapons rule intended to block her kind of kindness? Intention is key in how we live our life, and it is challenging because people take advantage of the situation. You know, maybe someone after her, if she would not have been expelled, maybe someone else would pretend to bring in brownies, pretend to bring in a knife to cut it, and misuse it. So it's a very complicated world. It is indeed a fine mess we find ourselves in, a nice mess we find ourselves in. And I was listening to Bug Out Brad on his YouTube channel. I'm not even sure what he's referring to, but he was commenting how he is never going to be politically correct. And it, again, what is his intention? There was a contest. It reminds me, not related to Bug Out Brad, it reminds me of a contest at a school during Black History Month, where cotton gin inventor Eli Whitney used to be honored during that month. But whatever, that's a topic I've already covered. So for Black History Month, they had the school had a contest, or not a contest, but to see, you know, how you crown a king and queen for prom, and they did the same thing for Black History Month. Who would be the king and queen of for Black History Month? And they changed it. It's Black History Month, but the contest was called African American. So who would be the king and queen for the African American contest? And the person who won was a Caucasian male, and he was expelled. Speaking of expelling. Because he was white. He's Caucasian. He's not black. The thing is, he is African American. He's a South African who moved here and is now an American citizen. So again, intention, where does it fall? So before you accuse someone of something negative, look at the intention. And when someone points a finger at you, understand that they may not have seen your intention. All right, everyone. I love you.